tonight, one of President Trump's judicial nominees going viral for the wrong reasons as Trump comes under fire for his nominee's qualifications. Two of them were withdrawn, one nominee failing to answer basic legal questions and admitting to a stunning lack of experience as well. Here's Matthew Spencer Petersen. He is a nominee at this moment to be a judge for life on a district court in Washington, D.C.
Have any of you not tried a case to verdict in a courtroom? Mr. Petersen, have you ever tried a jury trial?
I have not.
Civil?
No.
Criminal?
No.
Bench?
No.
State or federal court?
I have not.
Have you ever tried taken a deposition by yourself?
I believe no.
Okay. Have you ever argued a motion in state court?
I have not.
Have you ever argued a motion in federal court?
No.
Do you know what a motion in limine is?
Yes, I haven't. My background is not in litigation as when I was replying to Chairman Grassley. I haven't had to, do a deep dive. And I understand and I appreciate this line of questioning.
Just for the record, do you know what a motion in limine is?
I would probably not be able to give you a good definition right here at the table.
Do you know what the Younger abstention doctrine is?
I've heard of it, but I, sure. Again.
That, how about the Pullman abstention doctrine?
I heard
you're going to see, you'll all see that a lot in federal court.
Okay, that really happened. And now the man on the other end of that exchange, you saw him there, Republican Senator John Kennedy of Louisiana. He is a lawyer. Senator, I appreciate your time tonight. What was going through your head during that questioning?
Well, nobody has a better a voting record than I do, Aaron, with President Trump. But I have to do my job. I sit on the Judiciary Committee, and I don't think that the first time that you've ever stepped foot in a federal courtroom ought to be as a federal judge. I read Mr. Petersen's FBI background check. I feel badly for him. His background check is voluminous. It's, you can stand on the thing and paint the ceiling. Everybody in his background check says Mr. Petersen is smart and honest. And capable, but experience matters. And my job under our separation of powers doctrine inspired by Madison is to sort of be a check on nominees. The president doesn't interview these folks. He interviews folks for the U.S. Supreme Court, but he doesn't interview these nominees below the Supreme Court. He has a staff to do that and others, and sometimes mistakes are made and we're supposed to catch them. And that's my job.
So my question to you is, I mean, obviously it's pretty embarrassing, okay, that anybody questioned him and ended up putting someone in that in a position
like
that.
It was painful, and I feel very badly for Mr. Petersen. I think he's probably a very nice guy, but that's my job.
Right, well, that's not what this is about either, as you point out, right? This is about a federal judge. But my question to you is, did you, Senator, have any idea that this was going to be this painful? Or did you literally come up with those questions because he kept saying, no, you ever done a jury trial, a civil trial, a criminal trial, taken a deposition by yourself, state or federal court? I mean, were you coming in ready with that? Or did that just happen because you were so shocked with his response?
Well, I prepare, every senator prepares differently, Aaron. I spend a lot of time reading the resume. I try to read the background check for every nominee. Now, I can't all do it for all of them, but I do it for as many as I can. And I have a kind of a general idea. Some senators have their staffs prepare questions.
Yeah.
I don't generally do that. I do my own questioning. And my job is to try to understand whether this man or woman has the integrity and the experience to be appointed a federal judge for life with all of the power, the immense power of the United States government behind him.
So, Senator, let me ask you, because, you know, you point out, you've voted with the president, you point out, you know, he has interviewed every one of these judicial nominees.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not saying you're trying to excuse him, but you were saying, you know, people who work for him did this these interviews to pick this guy. They put out a statement. actually, about the criticism of Petersen, the Deputy Press Secretary Hogan Gidley. And in part, it says this, and I want to read it straight to you, Senator. It's no surprise the president's opponents keep trying to distract from the record-setting success the president has had on judicial nominations, which includes a Supreme Court justice and 12 outstanding circuit judges in his first year. Do you consider yourself an opponent of President Trump, as this statement seems to refer?
Oh, no. No, I'm not. I enthusiastically supported President Trump for President of the United States. I still support him.
So should they withdraw this nomination? I mean, they're standing by it. They're trying to say anyone who's criticizing him is trying to distract.
Well, the executive branch has its job to do, and I've been pretty supportive. I'm very fond of the president. I think he's a very bright guy. I know some disagree with that, but this is America. You're entitled to your opinion. I do think, but nobody's perfect. And the president, these are the president's nominees, but he didn't pick them. He didn't do the interviewing.
Right, but should he now say to his team, don't put out statements like that. This is embarrassing. This guy's not ready. Withdraw the nomination, right? Well, I mean, ultimately,
I don't know how the White House works there, and I'm a brand new senator. The only time I get to go to the White House is to take a tour. So I don't know how the internal White House works. I will say that I did raise objections on two of the president's other nominees. Once again, they're done in his name, but I don't believe for a second President Trump interviewed them. One of his nominees, for example, didn't tell us. It was revealed by the press. One of his nominees was caught blogging in support of the early Ku Klux Klan. And again, this is America. You can do what you want, but I can do what I want. And I said, I'm not going to vote for him. And they pulled him down. I'm hoping that the White House will pull down Mr. Petersen. I don't want to, I don't want to see him suffer. He's a nice guy, and I think he's whip smart,
right, but
probably.
But again, it's not about
but
that.
You can't just walk into a federal courthouse for the very first time and say, here I am, I think I want to be a judge. It just doesn't work that way, especially not the D.C. Circuit. The D.C. Circuit and the Southern District of New York are probably our two most important district courts, and you've got really experienced lawyers going at each other hammer and tong, and you're supposed to be the referee, and you've got to know what the Daubert doctrine is, and you've got to know what a motion in limine is, and you have to have read the federal rules of evidence and of civil procedure, and there are just certain minimum level of requirements. I don't care how smart you are. I mean, I think the president's smart, but if he were asked to go transplant a kidney in the morning, he couldn't do it. Neither could I. I think you're smart. But you couldn't go do brain surgery in the morning. Experience matters.